In urology, there are generally only few emergencies. Knowledge of these emergencies is not reserved for professionals. In fact, it is important for everyone to recognize them, because if they happen, you usually have to rush to the hospital. Fracture is one of them. It is not very common and accounts for one in every 175,000 emergency room admissions. However, I have met a lot of fracture patients who have never shown up at any emergency room. Embarrassment definitely is a barrier to seeking healthcare. My name is Stefan Buntrock. I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist. In one of my previous videos, I explained to you the fibro-skeleton of the penis. Several layers of thick tissue connected with intracavernosal pillars enable rigidity with erections. Unlike other species, the penis has no bone. So in a fracture, it is not a bone that breaks apart, but the fibroskeleton, more specifically the Tunica albuginea. It is made of collagen and is 2 millimeters thick. However, during erections, the tunica expands and thickness decreases to something between 0.25 to 0.5 millimeters. Any axial force applied will lead to unnatural bending and cause the tunica albuginea to burst. On UroChannel, I upload valuable information on urological and sexological topics, knowledge it took many years to acquire. I cover topics you won't easily find elsewhere on YouTube. If you like my content and think it could also be valuable to others, you can help to spread the word. Subscribe to UroChannel and hit the like button so the algorithm knows that it should show it to other people as well. If you are a super fan, consider supporting me by becoming a member of the Above Average Club. I would be very happy. When the tunica albuginea bursts, a popping sound can be heard. The erection is lost immediately, and a hematoma forms rapidly. In fact, there will be a resemblance to an eggplant within a short time span. Usually, the tunica has burst on one side. Bilateral damage is rather uncommon. In severe cases, also the urethra can get injured. So this is serious business. Here is what you do should this happen to you. Drive to the next hospital. Do not wait until the next day. Usually, the damage will have to be repaired surgically and fast. Evidence suggests that the outcome long-term is much better if surgery is done immediately. Problems that might arise later are erectile dysfunction and deformity. Therefore, it is recommended to get treatment within the first 24 hours. Why shouldn't you wait until the next day? Because I know hospitals. The clocks tick differently in there. 5 minutes in hospital equals several hours in the real world. It has to do with the high workload. You wouldn't believe the enormous stress a doctor on call is facing. So time passes quickly if you are a doctor and about to do a trillion tasks, all to be performed at once. For the single patient, this means to remain patient and wait. So the earlier you come to the emergency room, the better, because it will take several hours to take you to the operation room anyway. I mentioned the urethra. Any blood at the tip of the urethral opening, any inability to void, would be suspicious of urethral rupture. This has to be taken care of, as if left untreated, it may lead to scarring and difficulties with passing urine. But what if you decided to stay at home? There is not much in the literature about delayed treatment. As a rule of thumb, whatever the problem is, one will have to try to treat it when it occurs. However, chances for complete restoration are limited, so I can only advise you to seek help as soon as possible. One more thing, there is also such a thing as false fracture. It can't be distinguished from true fracture just by its symptoms. It presents with the same injury mechanism, the pain, the hematoma, but the cracking sound will be absent, and the erection will go down more gradual, but it doesn't have any consequences for management. Surgery will be the approach also here. The operation is usually performed by stripping the organ from the skin to expose the underlying anatomy. Then the defect within the tunica albuginea is closed with absorbable sutures. If there is no defect, the hematoma is taken care of, that's it. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.